our coaching staff and our players is just gonna always be ready for the challenge. Like I said before, our people just, we've been there. And the people in the locker room, me, CJ, BJ, Dante, Jason, we've been in close games before. And it's just good to be in those games sometimes because it's not gonna always be a 20-point blowout. You're gonna be in a row, you're gonna be blue outs, you're gonna be gray outs. It just shows a lot about the team's character. I feel like now we know we can go into any situation, adverse situation, get a job.
She's a hot little number in her pickup truck. Daddy sweet money done jacked it up. She's a party all night.
All right, here we go. Xavier basketball. Let's do this in 90 seconds. Easy game. Was never too much of a scare, even though LaSalle cut it to 11 in the second half. We ended up winning by 20, 73-53. We had a lead of max of about 22 points. Everyone played pretty well. McLean is struggling. What is going on with him? I've only seen one good game out of him, and that was against Memphis. Brad Redford, the most exciting player I like watching is Xavier in the past 5 years. Go ahead and try to find and name someone that's more exciting to watch and shoot. Every time he shoots it, you think it's going in. And I think Coach Miller also agrees that Brad Redford is a key to this team along with the other freshmen. Here's what he has to say.
He's doing a great job for us. He really is. He's one of the key freshmen that have allowed us to experience success. You know, Kenny Freeze, Terrell Holloway, and Brad, three freshmen, they have an important role on our team.
Also, I want to talk about Jason Love. He had 10 points, 9 boards. It's amazing to see where this guy's came from since his freshman year. Freshman year, he was a liability. It was like, oh no, Love's coming in. Sophomore year, he improved, and he gave us our 5-10 minutes to give subs for Duncan, etc. And now this year, he's the man. I mean, he's playing well. He's scoring points. He's an offensive rebounding machine. He just takes up space, and he's never really hurt us, and that's what we need out of that position. So I really like it. Next up, we have St. Bonnie's. Right now, we are 4-0 in the Atlantic 10. We will, I guarantee, be 5-0 in the Atlantic 10 after St. Bonnie's here in a couple days. And then we play at LSU, a non-conference game in the middle of our conference schedule. Kind of scary, kind of worried about it. This game has stuck out to me since the beginning of the year. So hopefully we can keep the train rolling here and get back in the top 10. Till then, let's go Muskies, and I'll see you later. Bye.
Well, you know, offensively, you know, we're gonna have to do what we do, actually.
You know, we want to compete for our conference championship. I think teams that have the goal of winning one are short-sighted because it's not about winning, it's about being in the race to win it, and there's a big difference.